Some people think that I am a real witch.
I have been known to buy like a love spell book to like bring love into Ooh. My life.
Well, wait, but you gotta tell me if it worked or not though.
It hasn't worked yet. Hello friends, my name is Ness Perez and I am a TV host, producer, podcaster, and founder of a support group called Heartbroken Anonymous, but I am also the host of this incredible show that you're watching right now called Get Ready With Me and JCP, where I get to talk to really cool influencers, founders, and just all around cool people, all while trying on products that you can buy at JCPenney Beauty. I love hosting this show because whenever I walk into a beauty counter, I feel like I get really easily overwhelmed by all the products. I never know what I could be using. So my hope is that through this show, you learn more about the person that I'm interviewing and about the products that you can get at JCPenney Beauty so you can decide for yourself what's best for you. Now, I'm really excited about today's episode because if you are a bride-to-be, you are in luck because I am interviewing and talking to the ultimate bride-to-be, Kimberly J. Brown, the iconic, the legendary, you guys may recognize her from the Halloween Town movies on Disney Channel. She played Marnie. She was also in Quince, Bringing Down the House, General Hospital. This woman can literally do it all, and she is engaged. And she has a bridal shower coming up and a bachelorette party. So we're gonna be getting ready for both of those with her. But without further ado, I'm so excited to introduce Kimberly J. Brown. I am feeling like, I wanna bring out my inner witch this episode because I love witches. We have to start off on behalf of every 90s kid. I just wanna say thank you for like your effervescence and your warmth and everything that you brought to any character that you embodied and still embody, because you are so much fun to watch and you're just so magnetic. And I like can't thank you. Believe that I feel like everyone's so excited that you're getting married next year, you know, like as fans.
Thank
of you.
You so much. That's so sweet. My goodness. That's such a kind way to start off. I'm so honored that people have just loved the movies for all of these years. We could have never have imagined that the DCOMs would become, you know, would become what they have now. And it's due in such a large part to all of the awesome fans. And it's just, I love that people still enjoy the movies.
We love them. I mean, they were such a gift to us, but also a gift to you in your life, because that's how you met your fiance, Daniel, who was your yes. co-star in Halloween 2, Calabar's Revenge. Like, insane. Also, I also just, for every Halloween Town fan out there, the fact that I get to talk to you on the 25th anniversary of Halloween Town is like yeah. the most epic. Like, I just feel like this is very epic. Walk me through your bridal shower look, and then okay. I want to know everything about how you and Daniel connected, because I know that you didn't actually connect on the movie. You connected years later. So first, let's yes. start off with your bridal shower look and what you're going for, and then we'll get into it.
Sounds perfect. Okay. Well, I think every good makeup look has to start with a primer, right? So yes. I'm going to start off with the e.l.f. Power Primer. And let's see. I guess people ask me all the time if Daniel and I had any feelings for each other when we worked together, which we did not. Right. We were good friends and had a good time filming. And then I guess about it was about 10, 12 years passed by where I didn't see him at all. We kind of stayed in touch over social media. And then I reached out to him asking if he would do some sketches for my YouTube channel. And we started hanging out and filming some of the sketches with my friends from my days at Second City. And then we started, what do the kids say now? Catching feelings. We started... kind of falling for each other a little bit. We were like, wow, this is happening. And yeah, and then we just never looked back. So next I go to usually put a foundation on because I love good coverage. So I'm going to use the Monica Blender Beauty, which actually doubles as concealer too. So we can put some on with our foundation brush and then also, you know, put a little extra on those spots that... you know, perhaps we don't want to peek out as much. I think it was gradual for us, but I think Daniel would agree with me that he probably made the first move. But I think the first time he kissed me was when I, you know, you kind of feel that extra shiver down your spine. And I just went,
yes, the best feeling ever.
It really is.
Oh my God, that's so crazy. Were you just like, I can't believe like that this manifested in this way? Like I met him through like being Marnie on Halloween Town.
It was really the last thing that I could have ever, you know, have expected. And it just kind of cracked me up because, you know, we waited a little bit to kind of make it public, but I was so excited to see the fans' reaction. And so many of them were, you know, so many of them still make Halloween Town references, like, watch your spell book, Marnie. And I, you know, but a lot of people really, really loved Marnie and Cal as a couple, even though I don't think that Marnie would have ever really gone back to him. He was pretty evil to her family.
But sometimes we do. We liked the bad boys back then in the 90s.
That is true. That is true.
Wait, can we talk about this foundation / concealer? Like, this is...
Yes.
This blunder cover, I think, is my new favorite foundation. The fact that you don't have to put concealer on, and it's blending so nicely and fitting so well.
That's what I was
going to
say. I love how... Yeah. I love how smooth and kind of creamy it is. And yet it, like, it stays right where you put it, you know? Some, like... I hate it when a foundation, like, you try to blend it in, and it just moves with the brush. And you're like, no, wait. I wanted you to stay right there. Yeah. I needed you in that spot.
I didn't want to watercolor my face.
Exactly.
I'm wearing the 4.25 if anyone's wondering, but this color looks, I'm like loving this.
I've got the 2.5
over here.
Okay, I have
so many questions. So what is the theme to your bridal shower? If it's not Halloween related.
Well, I didn't really pick like a specific theme. I just wanted it to be very feminine and kind of along the lines of my wedding, like feminine and a little bit rustic, but with a, like kind of a little bit more of a modern touch. Because I feel like all of those themes are kind of I'm a combination of all of those themes, I guess. And it was so hard to like narrow it down to one look or feel. So we're kind of doing, you know, a little bit of everything, like the light, you know, the pinks and, but maybe with a little bit of some black or silver accents and just kind of, you know, I feel like that's kind of the best expression of like my personality and what I like. And I think it'll be really cool when it all comes together.
It's cool how it's so much fun to pick out different things that you feel like you can express yourself through, you know, whether it's like feminine with a couple of like masculine touches and you're like, this is me in a flower vase, you know? Yeah. I think it's like, it's so much fun. Is anyone putting on the bridal shower for you, or do you like to plan everything? And then what's next in your makeup look step?
Yes. I feel like this would be a good time to set the foundation and concealer look. So, I've got the Uama, the setting powder.
I love going like this, Kimberly. I always feel like so proper.
I'm always and that's how the pros do it, you know, on the sets and everything, you know, they gotta, I do the same thing too. So we're on the same page. Cause you know, it just doesn't, you don't feel like it hits the brush correctly until you slightly tap it off. Just a little.
Like so annoying. That's so funny. Okay, so are you planning your own bridal shower? Do you sort of like when other people plan things for you, or do you like to get in and do all of it?
I have to say, I am not good at letting other people do things for me. Like, I want to be like, my best friend's throwing my shower, and though I'm having the hardest time of not being like, well, let me do this part or whatever, you know, she is always telling me like, no, I am doing this. Like we get into
bridal shower for anyone watching. Like that is the time to literally be showered, you know, like let people shower you. Wait, tell me what's next in your bridal shower look.
I like going to the eyes before I finish the face. So, I'm going to start, I think with the, I have this awesome Revival eyeshadow palette.
It's so beautiful. Look at these colors.
It really is. It's kind of the perfect mix of some great neutral browns, and then you get those sparkly, and you can do all over the eye too, because I like to do, you know, a little bit of the lighter color up here, and I just like, I love this palette, so.
Okay, what's a good natural color for sort of an all-day bridal shower look from this palette?
I love the strength color. I also love that it's called strength.
Yes.
Because you get to kind of play with more of a neutral everyday look for the shower, and then, you know, kind of transition to a more, you know, nighttime smoky look then. So this, this one does it great. And again, we're tapping our brushes. Tap, tap.
Yes, we're tapping.
We're tapping.
I also just, it just makes me feel like a witch too, you know? I love it.
It's a different kind of, I never thought of a makeup brush being a different kind of magic wand. You know, you're,
well, listen,
you're putting
a
little magic,
magic
on your face.
We're creating magic. We are. Do you put strength all over your eyelid?
I do. I like to go in the crease and on the base of my eyelid. And then I usually kind of blend it in a little bit. And
this is a really pretty color.
I love
this
color. Yeah. So warm.
So good.
Yeah.
Amazing. So at the bridal shower, do you know what you're going to be wearing?
I've tried on some beautiful, like, white dresses, and I think it's, like, the perfect opportunity to really just embrace, like, the girly girl, you know, like, the, I love that feeling. So, I think I've got it narrowed down to the dress I like, and I'm playing with some, I figure I'd start the day in some heels and then get some nice flats, you know, for when the feet start to ache.
Okay, so our eyes look great.
Yes.
What do you do after your eyes are set?
Well, hello. We can't forget the liner and the mascara. I think we did a little shadow, and we have this Black Cocoa pencil by Pixi is one of my favorites because I like black eyeliner, but I guess I've always associated it with more evening like type events and stuff. So I love a good dark brown because you can kind of it goes with the warmth of the usual like daytime look that I do. So I like to go across the eyelid a little bit, and I love these because they're so smooth and you can.
Oh my
really,
god, this is so silky.
It really is. You can play
it's
with,
called
you know,
silk too, right? Whoa,
they are,
endless
actually,
silky
right.
Eye pen. It literally feels like you're putting silk on your eyelid.
It does. It goes on so easily. And
oh my goodness. To do. It feels like you're painting with a crayon.
It does. It really does.
I've
used pencils in the past. It almost felt like I was scratching the skin off. So this is, I love this. I like to do a little bit underneath. Too.
I have a black one,
and
but
smooth
I think
it
for
out.
Daytime, I'm just going to do like a little.
Oh, no, I love that, though.
Yeah, very little.
I'm so like fair-skinned and light, you know, like the black looks great on you.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. What do you think? Did you ever get to talk to Debbie Reynolds, who was, you know, such a legend in the Halloween Town movies, who you got to work with, about being with Daniel before she passed? Because I'm not sure if that happened
I
before
didn't.
Or after.
No.
No.
She passed away, I guess it was about 6 or 7 years ago now. She was such an incredible lady. I could talk for hours about how great she was. And we had just a true, genuine friendship on top of, like, our relationship very much started to mirror Marnie and Aggie's. Like, we had the best time together, and after we finished filming, I went and saw some of her variety shows, and she would travel and perform, and we went to dinner a few times, and man, it was so fun to watch her come out, because she had so many fans that just loved her, and they just went wild, and it was just, it was always the consummate performer, and she genuinely loved performing, so it taught me a lot when I was younger, like, just, you know, what a gift that is. And I wish she could have. I mean, I'm sure she watches over us now. But
she. What do you think she would say if she knew that you and Daniel were engaged?
Oh, I think she would totally approve. I think she would. I think she would get a kick out of it. Really. I mean, she loved to talk about all of the things. She had such an illustrious career and life and. She loved when all of those types of things came together in the right way. So I'm sure she would just be tickled by it.
I love it. Oh, we're all tickled by it. It's so cool.
I was going to say, I love that this is such a bright purple. Cause you know, a lot of times you just need like a little mascara touch up, or you're looking for the mascara and it's like, oh, there it is. Like it can't get buried. And this brush is perfect. It's
so good. So I actually have brown mascara, which I'm really into right now. I think it gives it like a nice light, like just sort of like more natural look when you put brown mascara on. I love it. But you're so right, Kimberly. Every time I'm like looking in my bag and like I have a product that's black, I can't find it.
So many products are black. They all just, it's like camouflage. They all just look the same. And you're like, no, I just need this. So I love these like vibrant colors on this because it's makes it so much easier. And this brush, wow, I love how this goes on because it doesn't clump your lashes. So I figured now that we have our eyes done that we can go in and finish the rest of our face with some good blush and bronzer.
Yes.
So we've got these great Jason Wu bronzer. Let's start with that because...
Oh, I love him so much.
I do too.
And it's so cool that you can get his stuff at JCPenney Beauty. Jason Wu has been...
Totally.
He's such a pioneer, whether it's like in the fashion world, in the beauty world. I love all his stuff and I've never tried any of these. What's your go-to for a daytime look as far as like
it's going to be that middle brown because it's such a like a warm like chestnut to me and I love...
Yeah.
I love like warming up the whole look, you know? We'll do the little... Tap, tap.
We'll do the tap, tap.
We'll do the tap,
I feel
tap,
like the
tap.
Bronzer makes you go from, like, a ghost to, like, a witch, you know?
Yes.
I have been known, Kimberly, back in the day to have buy, like, a love spell book to, like, bring love into my life. So what's your advice
out
there?
Well, wait, but you got to tell me if it worked or not, though. Did it work?
It hasn't worked yet.
It hasn't worked? Okay. Some people think that I am a real witch sometimes, and I'm sure they're slightly disappointed when they find out that I am not, that it was just a role.
Well, do you consider yourself to be like, you know, to have like an inner witch inside of you?
I feel like there are aspects of Marnie to me. You know, there was so much of my personality in her, but I also feel like there was so much about her that I admire. And so like her courage and her determination, and she took so many risks. And like, I was 13 when we filmed the first movie. And so it was really inspiring to me, even though obviously she's a fictional character, but like, it was inspiring to me how she kind of just took on her family's legacy and was like, no, I'm going to find this out. Like,
yeah.
And so it was cool as a teenager to get to play that and also, kind of take those aspects of Marnie with me, hopefully. I wish I could have taken a little bit more of the magic, you know, to get through Los Angeles traffic and stuff. Like, if I could fly on a broom, that would be great.
You talk about how pretty this palette is for some
I love that one. Yes.
I feel like it's like a swatch, you know, where I'm like, what color do I want to put on my face?
That actually, yeah, it matches your shirt perfectly. That one on the end, that's gorgeous.
Which this is also a Jason Wu blush palette. Which one are you going for?
I'm going for this light pink on the end because I feel like it's such a soft, like, pretty pink, you know, pop your cheeks for daytime, you know? I love this a lot.
I love it. It's so funny. I used to hate blush.
Oh, really?
Like, I didn't hate blush. I just didn't really wear blush. And now blush is so in. And I think I've come to really appreciate how alive it can make you look, you know?
It really does. It kind of, there have been times, it was one time recently where I left the house having done all of my makeup except my blush and my bronzer and took a couple photos with friends and then saw them later and was like, oh boy, like, you don't realize how, like, you start to miss that, you know? I was like, okay, not doing that again. I need a little rosiness on the cheeks.
Yes, I think I went way too ham on the blush, so I'm just going to take my blender and take some off. I love it, though. It's so fun.
I do, too. It's hard not to know until, like, sometimes when you put it on, you don't know how much you need until it's on. But,
yeah.
No, I love that. It looks great. One of my favorite products is you gotta set it. So I love this Pixie Makeup Fixing Mist. It smells delightful. You spritz it over to set your makeup. And I love actually also that you can spray it throughout the day on your face to kind of refresh your look and kind of, you know, make it look, hydrate it and balance it. So I love this stuff, but we're going to, yeah, let's spray. Let me make sure. Okay, there we go. Let's spray and from a distance.
It feels so good. And it smells amazing.
I love that rose smell. Yeah. Kind of set everything in. Yep.
Seriously, just go and open this and smell it. It smells so good.
Yeah, exactly. And then
I love it.
We have left is our lips.
Our lips?
Yes. You gotta love a good tint lip. And this TikTok cashmere is the color. But I love this I Am Meme TikTok lip tint because it's kind of an all-in-one application. You know, it's got the little clicker.
Nice.
And yeah, I love the cashmere is like a fun daytime color, I think. So you click it and bring it up.
Oh my god,
this color
is so pretty.
Isn't it pretty?
And it feels really soft on your lip, and
it does.
Oh, wow. And it's nice and matte but creamy.
I was just going to say the same thing. I love the matte texture on it.
Wait, I love every product you picked out because remember how we were talking about how silky the eyeliner is?
Mm-hmm.
The Pixie eyeliner. This also feels very silky on the lip.
It really does. And I love that I think it helps it kind of set in. You know, sometimes when stuff is too glossy, you don't know if it's going to slide and move around throughout the day. This stays so well because of the soft matte texture. And you don't.
Wow. Oh my God.
It kind of does a little bit of the whole like lipstick and liner look. You know, it's kind of it's really all you need.
It's an all in one. Oh
yes.
My goodness. Wait, I'm obsessed with this. I wish everyone watching could feel how it feels on your lip, but it's so soft. It's like a satin pillowcase on your lip.
That's the perfect explanation. Yeah,
wow.
Perfect description.
TikTok tint lip, cashmere. Mm-hmm. This is the color cashmere. You're absolutely right. You don't need a lip liner.
Mm-mm, no.
All right, Kimberly, we are looking amazing. We are looking bridal. But before we transition from our bridal shower look to our bachelorette party look, we first need to get some tips on how to keep this look fresh all day long. So we are going to hear from JCP beauty expert Lanique Fortune right now on all the must-have touch-up products that every bride needs in her bag.
Hi, my name is Lanique Fortune, and I'm a beauty expert here at JCPenney. Today, I wanted to share some tips with you that you can use leading up to your wedding day. Tip number one, always ensure you buy some cute little minis to throw in your wedding bag. That way, leading up to your event, you'll always make sure that all the pictures your friends snap and post, you'll be looking fresh. Start with a mascara. We know that you want your eyes to look beautiful and doe-eyed for that day, even leading up to it. Next, make sure you have a concealer. A concealer is going to make sure that your makeup continues to look flawless and keep that glow about your face when you're out and about looking at wedding dresses, having champagne and mimosas with your girls for your bridal shower. Lastly, don't forget a quick lip and cheek product. This is an easy product that you can use on your lips and your cheek to keep that beautiful glow, natural flush, to give you a beautiful look all day long. Tip number two, always get you a good setting spray. A setting spray is going to make sure that you can keep your makeup looking fresh all day. And also, if you just need a refresher, it also helps seal in your fragrance so you can smell great while you're rushing in and out of boutiques, getting your wedding stuff together. I'm so glad I got to share these wedding tips with you today, and I wish you the best.
Okay, friends, we did our day bridal shower look, and now, Kimberly, I would love for you to walk us through your bachelorette party look, because we're going to go extra hard.
Oh, we are going for a night out.
We're going for a night out.
Night out. I don't know why I did that.
Me neither, but
we went with it. So let's start with the eyes. I love a good smoky eye in the evening, you know, and this palette, again, is so great. It has more of those shimmery colors, like the powerful and confidence. So I'm going to add a little more shimmer to my lid because Because, you know,
because we don't need a reason. Okay. So everyone watching, this is the Shades by Shan, and the Powerful is so cool. I feel like do you put it all over your lid or just in the corner?
I'm going to try it a little bit on the inner corner and see. Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah.
That's yeah. Cause it's a little intense. I'm going to keep it. Like comes it out, is. That's it's glittery, yes. But let's see what it looks like.
Ooh, that's pretty.
Ooh.
Okay. Do this.
Ooh, I really like this actually.
It's yes.
Okay. I need to know everything, Kimberly, about your bachelorette party. Where is it? Is your sister and best friend also planning that for you?
So I haven't actually been told everything that they're trying to put together. They know that I love some good Mexican food, so I think we might do like a nice dinner with a little tequila because tequila is the best.
Dogs are a man's best friend, tequila is a woman's best friend.
I like that. That's a great way of putting it. So I think we'll probably do a really nice dinner. And I'm a karaoke fan. Like, take me to a place and let me belt out Don't Stop Believin', and I am good to go. You know, my night is
made. Is that your go-to karaoke song?
Yes. Yes. Oh, I was going to say, speaking of shimmer, we got to add a little highlighter to our cheeks.
Honestly, the blush, the bronzer, and the highlight palette from Jason Wu, like, is the trifecta.
Yes.
Like, I would just buy all three because all these colors, like, blend seamlessly. Which is your go-to highlight for, like, a night out?
I love the shimmer with a little bit of pink in it because I think it pops a little bit more. You know, I would use the golden one for maybe a little bit more of a natural look, but I love the pink shimmer for the evening.
Okay, so do you just put it right above?
I put it right above, I guess, the top of your cheekbone, I guess it is. The upper edge of your blush to kind of give that nice shimmer. And then
it always makes me feel like a mermaid, like I'm like putting on my gills.
Yeah. Oh, I like that.
I love it. So are you this is so pretty. Wow.
It's a delicate sheen, you know? It doesn't look like you powdered a bunch of stuff on your face, you know? It's just, it's so pretty.
I like the pink one too, because it blends into the blush really well.
Exactly. Yep.
I love it. So are you the type of bride that when you're on a bachelorette party, like, do you do the sash, the crown? You know, like, are you going to go all out in that
I
way?
I do have some of those. I already have a sash. I have a crown. It's just, it's going to have to be as blatant as all ever, because when else do you get to go full princess mode and do the sash and the crown and all of it? Like, you got to do it. Like, it's the whole night you get to do it. Like,
you have to. It's your night. I love it. Okay, so we have our eyeshadow on. We put more liner on. We put highlighter on. What's another way we can take our day look to a bachelorette party?
Well, you can take your, like, the Jason Wu blush and bronzer palettes and freshen up, like, your blush. I like this little bit darker of a pink color. Because it's just a little, you know, a little bit more pronounced for the evening, and it's just taking these same things we used for the bridal shower and just, you know, amping them up just a little bit.
Are you the type, Kimberly, because I know that you have done Broadway.
Yes.
So are you just like, when you go up there, are you like Broadway stage, like the vocals are coming out, you know, you got a little tequila in you?
I mean, if I have tequila in me, yes. Sometimes I get a little self-conscious. I also sometimes have to hold myself back from picking a Broadway musical.
Okay, so what, now we got our bronzer on, should we do lip?
Yes, let's do a lip. I love this Shades by Shan set. It's got the glossy lipstick, I guess you could call it, and then the liner that comes with it.
I love that the lip liner is the same name as the lip gloss, because it makes it so easy to pair. Because sometimes I never know. I'm like, what color lip liner would look good with this lip gloss? So I love that Shades by Shan makes it super easy. And this color just is very neutral. And I really like it.
It goes on just so smoothly.
Yeah. Wow. You picked like the silkiest, smoothiest products at JCP Beauty. Truly.
It's all about ease and comfort too when you're putting on your makeup. You know, you got to enjoy the process, and all of these products just make it so easy and fun to put them all on.
No, it is so fun. I have to ask you, what are your predictions for your whole bachelorette party in general? Like, what do you think is going to go down?
Well, I mean, I feel like you usually have a friend that probably, you know, sometimes drinks a little too much. I'm usually the one that is like watching, you know, myself throughout the night, especially at a hangout like that, because, you know, I mean, you gotta pace yourself is, I guess, what I'm trying to say. But I think there's going to be a lot of laughter. A lot of my friends are young moms, and so it's going to be a really exciting night out for all of us.
Yeah.
And we've all known each other for a long time and are so close that it's so fun to have that level of like of comfortability and just, you know, like you get to hang out with your besties and just and celebrate, you know, kind of extends the whole wedding celebration into these other events. I love these traditions because you get to party on, you know, different days and you don't have to wait just for the wedding day.
Wow. Well, thanks for making us all feel like kids and play into our inner child through every role that you've done. And thanks for getting ready with us and showing us your bridal shower look and your bachelorette party look. You just look incredible, Kimberly J. Brown, and we are so excited for you. And thank you to everyone watching. Thanks, guys, for tuning in to Get Ready With Me and JCP. Make sure that you check out all of our previous episodes and subscribe and hit that bell. It's free so you don't miss out on any of our future episodes. My name is Naz Perez. I'm single, by the way, and I feel like I'm ready to get married after this episode. Thank you, Kimberly. We love you, and I'll see you guys next time.
Thank you.